What's up, my friends? Do not be scared, I'm talking again. Let us not waste so much time and get straight to the deck. First of all, the benefits of Metasys Assassin compared to Mine Assassin. The best benefit is clearly that the classes are completely not important in this deck. With Mine Assassin you need a high Mine Dice, the higher the better. But with Metasys it doesn't matter if you have class 10 legendaries or class 7. The second very good benefit is that you can control your SP and you can reach 105 pips much faster. The third and not bad benefit is that you can help your opponent with more SP to set up his board correctly, or you can sometimes hold the runes longer, which can be very helpful for Galaxy or Combo Moon. The only disadvantage I see with this support deck is time. The games will take 10 to 20 minutes longer than without Metasys. But if you are aiming for high rounds, then these few minutes are not the end. It's better to play 10 to 20 minutes longer, but to get to the goal more safely. Anyway, that were the benefits and drawbacks, and now we already come to the explanation. Before we start with the explanation, these gameplays are with Galaxy. But in the theory you play it always the same way with this support deck. Except with Overheat. There are very small things you can change, but I talk about that especially in an Overheat video. Before we watch the gameplays, we will clear the game parts. There is also an early, mid and late game with Assassin Metasys. Early game is from wave 1 to 10, mid game is from wave 11 to 20, and late game is from 21 until you reach 105 pips for your opponent. So, of course we start with the early part. By the way, if you want to skip the explanation and just watch the summary, you can skip to minute 8:25. From wave 1 to 10, copy all the assassins you get and don't merge any Metasys dice before wave 10. Maybe you have to wait with the assassins too. If your opponent sets a moon and a sun and you shoot up the moon at the beginning so you can survive the night, you can use your assassins before wave 10. But if he doesn't, then wait until he's done with the setup. And if he's done with the setup, then we will be in the mid game. In the mid game you can finally merge your assassins and Metasys. First the Metasys so that your opponent can finish his setup faster. Then the assassins. In this round I had to send so many assassins that I was sure we would survive the night. If you start with a high moon and don't have this problem, just send the assassins you have lying there and stop merging. Again, I had to merge Metasys to get more assassins to be sure of surviving the night. Normally I only merge red Metasys dice before night. If I shot all my assassins away and only normal metas are lying there, then I prefer to wait until night turns me and maybe I get red metas again. After night spins me, I don't really merge anything until wave 21. If I do, I send a few assassins that are lying there to prepare my metas for wave 21 again. So, we wait and leave the board like this until wave 21. Except the magic can hit something, we can save. Then of course we save the dice. That's it for the mid game and we are quickly on the last part, the late game, the most important part. What is our goal? 105 pips. What do we need for that? SP and assassins. I always try to stick to my rules as much as possible. My rules are 1, 2 and 3 pips are for assassins and 4, 5, 6 and also 7 pips are for Metasys. Why 7? If Lion puts me down, it can be red Metasys again, so always copy the 7 pips to Metasys too. Use your jokers and copy some 3 pips Metasys at the beginning too to get red Metasys. Red Metasys increase the SP count of a normal Metasys 10 times. That means a 6 pip red Metasys dice gives 6000 per side instead of only 600 SP. If you merge 2 red Metasys dice together, then that doubles again, so you get 12k per side. But if you play with Luminous Prisma as battlefield skin, it makes more sense to merge the red Metasys with normal or mimic dice, instead of merging 2 red Metasys together. This way you double your chance to get the effect of Luminous Prisma and at the same time you can get more SP. So again, 2 6 pips of red Metasys dice gives you 12k per side. 12k multiplied by 2 is 24k. If you merge 2 red Metasys each with Mimic or Metasys, you get 2x6k per side, which is also 24k in the end. Only you have 2x the chance of the doubling effect of Luminous. Try always to have 50 to 100k SP. Make room and get as many 1 pips as you can to copy Assassins. If you get a high red meta this dice, try to merge it before a boss takes it away again, and watch your SP and summoner cost. I always do it like this so I can estimate it better. I calculate my summoner cost multiplied by 10 and then I know around how much 10 new dice will cost me. If I see I have 60k SP and 10 new dice cost me 20k, then I know I can spawn 20 to 30 new dice so I don't have to worry. Because besides Assassin, there will definitely be new metas as well. But if I only have 30k SP and my cost is already close to 2k or more, then I have to be careful and try not to summon any more dice. I would wait for bosses like I did in this round, and hope they give me red metas so I have enough SP again to buy dice without worries, spam Assassins, survive bosses and still keep a full board. At the same time, I pay attention to what and how much I have to hit on my opponent's board. If I see there is only one dice missing and I have enough SP, then I can only concentrate on Assassins and hit out everything I can. My board will be closed anyway before my SP runs out, and then if it is not at 105 pips, I have to wait for the bosses to make room for me again. The bosses. Please don't forget to calculate the bosses. If you see you don't have anything you want or your board will be closed at any moment, and even if you have maybe high meters as 6 or 7 pips on your board, then work with the bosses. That means if you don't have what you want, let knight spin you. If your board gets closed, magic and online can make room for you again, and also meters can be turned into red meters by lion and with some luck also by knight. Watch the waves. You know when the first boss is coming, so you can for example leave your metas there hoping that the second lion will appear and they will turn red. But you should also calculate how much it would benefit you to merge them quickly before a knight appears and change it to grow. Every game I have played with this deck up to now I have reached 105 pips, always between wave 40 and 70, but mostly between wave 40 and 50. In very good rounds even before wave 40, and the bad rounds always run on wave 60 to 70. 105 pips will be reached in any case, sooner or later. Only provided that you are still concentrated enough to continue playing at the late game. Don't worry, Eski, we will forget this accident. Another benefit of Assassin Metasys is that you can delay the waves, especially with Galaxy, so that the opponent has it easier to position his stars. Summarized again. Wave 1 to 10, fill up the board, copy Assassins, do not merge metas and wait for a finished setup or shoot up the moon. Wave 11 to 20, send a few metas to set up the board, send Assassins off until only metas are there again and wait for night. Merge red metas before night and wait after night until wave 21. And at wave 21, start with metas spam and focus on red metas. 1, 2 and 3 pips are for Assassins and 4, 5, 6 and 7 pips for metas. Pay attention to your SP and summoner cost and don't forget the bosses. And keep an eye on the opponent's board, and when you have reached 105 pips, you are done and you can go back to sleep. That's it with the explanation. As I said, practice makes perfect. But you don't really need much practice for this deck, so have fun and good luck with it. Exhausting 10 minutes, saying metas so often was more exhausting than I thought. I hope you liked it and it will help you. I will let you watch the rest of the game without me. Ivan's classes are 10. With this gameplay you can also understand why you need at least class 12 moon to make sword really effective. So enjoy the game and see you soon my brothers and sisters.
Young